Hi, I am Anuj Gupta from Angel Broking. We are covering weekly review and outlook on commodity and currency. First, we start with the gold. We have noticed that in the last week, gold prices had made a lifetime high of ₹47,327 per 10 grams. And in international market, it has touched the 6-month high of $1,747 per ounce in the spot. This was due to the global growth forecast cut by IMF and highest jobless claim reported in the US. Even a dollar index also corrected from the weekly highest level of 100.39 to 98.81 levels. In the last trading session of the week, gold prices have corrected from the highest level to $1,677 per ounce on the back of the highest chances of reopen of the economies from lockdown. For the next week, in gold, we are expecting to sideways to upside momentum. Gold has a strong support at 45,200 to 45,000 and very strong support at 44,300 levels. Resistance at 46,300 to 46,500 levels and strong resistance at 47,400 levels. We are recommending to buy in any correction as the trend of gold is still a positive. Silver also perform in same tandem with the gold. However, silver corrected 1.60% in last week. It has strong zone support zone at 40,900 to 41,100 levels and strong support at 39,700 to 39,500. Resistance at 44,400 to 41,100 levels and strong resistance at 45,400. Now, if we talk about the base metal. In base metal, it is expecting that economies may reopen from lockdown, so the industrial activities may resume and the demand of base metal may increase in the next weeks as major economies are expected to open or given some relaxation in the lockdown. So the industrial activities may resume in the major economies. In the last week, copper increased by 2.72% and able to break 400 levels and finally closed at 402.50 levels. This means the trend of copper has been shifted from downside to upside. So we are recommending to buy in copper. For the next week, base metal may trade in a positive side. If we talk about the copper, copper has a support level at 395 to 397 levels and strong very strong support at 389 level, resistance at 409 to 411 levels and strong resistance at 416 level. We are expecting a positive side, so we are recommending in copper to buy in any dip. Now if we talk about the crude oil prices, which hit majorly in last week, crude oil lost 21.86% and touch the 19-year low of $17.31 per barrel level. Downtrend, higher supplies, lower demand of the crude oil are the major reason behind this correction in crude oil. Now the trend and the demand of crude oil is still low. So we are expecting that this downside rally may still intact on the pages. We are expecting crude price may go in downside further. If we talk about the support and resistance level, it has a strong support at $15 to $16 per barrel and strong support at $12 per barrel. Resistance zone at $23 to $25 per barrel. We are recommending to sell on a rise in crude oil prices. The demand is the major concern for the crude oil prices. If demand increase, then we will see a trend reversal in the crude oil prices. So for the trend reversal, we should look after the demand of the crude oil prices. Now in currency segment, we are talk about the USD INR. In last week, rupee was also depreciated by 0.73%. However, in that time, it touched the lifetime low level of 76.9 level in spot rupee level. In the last week, RBI governor reduced repo rate by 25 basis point from 4% to 3.75%. Under liquidity adjustment to infuse liquidity,